One out of every 10 children born here in the Bahamas are diagnosed with heart complications and need a life-altering surgery just to survive. Well, in this Matters of the Heart series, a young mother talks about her son's heart diagnosis, surgery, and his road to recovery.
As they explained it, I understand that he was going to be fine.
Becoming a mother for a second time was one of the greatest moments for 26-year-old Darrenika Nixon. But the news that her son, 9-month-old Tayshawn Barr, was born with Down syndrome, which led to a hole in his heart, caught her and her family by surprise.
The first reaction that came to me, I just started crying. I was sitting next to my mother, my aunt, and his father. He just got up and walked off to cry. I couldn't even speak. I didn't know what was going on, but as Dr. Leibold explained to me that because he had trimethoxazole 21, it's more reasonable for him to have the hole in his heart, for him to be missing those chambers, those ventricles. I didn't know what to do.
The next step was to get that complex surgery that little Tayshawn needed to save his life. Nixon says the surgery cost $75,000, money she said she simply did not have.
Dr. Leibman told us to go Cable Beach. You go straight to the Heart Foundation, you talk to Miss Linda LaFleur. As soon as we came out of NICU, we just drove straight to her. I didn't know. That's the only thing that was on my mind, just getting him better and speaking to Miss Linda LaFleur. I sat down, I talked to her, and she told me that, do not cry, everything was going to be fine, we're going to deal with it. She said, we're going to sell some tickets for the Heart Foundation, we're going to get some sponsors, your baby's going to be just fine.
Like Tayshawn, doctors say that there are thousands of babies born with holes in their hearts or heart complications here in the Bahamas. And while the surgery on October 10th last year was a successful one, Darrenika says her faith kept her strong.
They said we made it our first cut into him at 9 a.m. I said, okay, I just broke down crying, and there she sat there, she held my hand, and they came back at 5 o'clock, say he was fine. We saw him at 6 o'clock. After we saw him, we spent the night with him, 2 a.m., they said, okay, Miss Nixon, your son's not breathing on his own. They took him back and they made another cut into him. I just broke down crying again. We were there for a month, but as you can see, he's happy and I couldn't ask for nothing more.
And during Tayshawn's visit to pediatric cardiologist Dr. Jerome Lightborn's office, I too took one for the team and had my heart checked out. Everything turned out fine, but in Tayshawn's case, Darrenika says his condition is almost normal.
Dr. Lightborn, the end of last month, Dr. Lightborn said, well, Ms. Nixon, you want the good news? He said, I don't see anything on this monitor for Tayshawn, all the AVs, he said, and there's no leakage, he's perfectly fine. We're just working on getting him off the medication, getting him walking and therapy and moving forward.